A ja teraz zapraszam na scenę naszego przyjaciela z Chorwacji, Amira Spahića z Uniwersytetu w Zagrzebiu, który opowie, w jaki sposób zarządzanie wiedzą, w jaki sposób firmy chorwackie zarządzają wiedzą i mam nadzieję, że to Państwa zainteresuje. Amir, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Marta. I hope I did not understand much of Polish, but I understood that you already know my name. I will tell you about our experience of participating this project. I will not give you any lecture about knowledge management, but just share our experience and our lessons learned, and hopefully it will be useful for you as well. So the title of the presentation in Polish, I think it's how it's done in Croatia, but I put some more details to this title slide. So it's just five companies, I will tell you for sure, and maybe some 15 companies more that we met during some project activities. But I think our results can be also taken on a national level. So preparing this presentation, I even had idea to change the title in how it's not done in Croatia. So you will see what I mean later on. I just want to have a short introduction who I am and which is my home institution. So I'm Amir Spahić. I'm a head of our Center for International Projects. And this is our faculty, our beautiful city of Varaždin. If you had chance to travel to Adria, Adriatic coast, probably you passed right next to the city. So next time you will go to Croatia to have a holiday on our coast, please stop and enjoy some time in Varaždin as well. From the beginning, we were not part of this project because we were experts in knowledge management. Of course, we are IT faculty. We also have some business part of our courses. We know because our role was training in knowledge management tools. Of course, we use a lot of those tools, so it was not a problem for us. But we hope that we will find some knowledge management expertise close to us, and we will involve some more people during the project implementation. And we also had a good ground in this building. This is a technology park in Varaždin. It's considered one of the most successful technology parks in Croatia, and there is lots of IT companies inside, and so we thought we have a really good ground to successfully participate this project. All the information I will present you were gathered during the project activities. I did not use any external source, like some research papers published in Croatia, but even if I wanted, I would not find any. So this was a big shock in the beginning of the project when we had this desk research phase of the project. We just found few scientific papers dealing with small and medium companies and knowledge management. So when I say few, it's less than five. Just mentioning and just one paper who is targeting small and medium sized enterprises in the context of knowledge management. So this was quite a shock in the beginning. So then we got a feeling that we will be the ones who are experts in knowledge management. We were afraid of this because none of us was expert in knowledge management. Then in this desk research phase, we contacted a lot of companies. We sent some questionnaires, and we wanted to find out, but you will hear about this on the next slide. And we get a lot of information back. And I also included in this presentation our own case study, because we were not thinking knowledge management structural, in a structural way. on our institution. We had lots of tools. We have lots of services for our own purpose, which now we call knowledge management tools. But we were not aware that those were knowledge management tools. We were just using some services for lectures, for internal trainings, whatever. And in the later phase of the project, we organized trainings for the companies. And in this phase, we also got some feedback from them. And in the end of the project, the last phase, we were working closely with five companies in implementing their own knowledge management strategies. And this is the part where we got the best insight. So for this first step of the project, this desk research, we sent over 13,000 emails or questionnaires to different companies, and this is the number for the whole project in all 1 to 5 countries, Germany, Poland, Croatia, Spain, so it's 4 countries participating this project. And we got back 202 questionnaires which were correctly filled. This was the structure of the questionnaire. So we had some one section about the company itself, then the role of knowledge management in the company, and some practice of knowledge management in those companies. And we also asked some questions about what kind of trainings do they need, because in the later phase of the project, we should organize some trainings for them as well. These are some findings from Croatia. So we sent more than 300 questionnaires to more than 300 email addresses, different companies, and most of those contacts were heads or some heads of some departments, so it's high level. And we received just 11 questionnaires back. And these 11 questionnaires were results of first prolongation of the time they have to return the questionnaire. And in the end, we also had to call our own private contacts and saying, please, can you just fill this up? It's very important for our project. So, and this was another shock, because we were expecting some more feedback from companies. But I think, I don't know how it's in Poland, but in Croatia, companies are not very happy to fill some questionnaires. And even when you organize some trainings for free, they are not so interested. So if you put a price on it, they are more interested, and this is our own experience. So, and even if it's more expensive, you have more people than it's free, because I don't know, we have still this socialist background when everyone thinks that education is for free and it's not a very big value. But if you have to pay for it, then it's something serious. So most of the companies we got reply from were technology sector, because we have a contact to technology sector the most, because we are IT faculty. And we also have some replies from some other sectors. So it was equal distribution of company size, and 83% of people filling the questionnaires were highly ranked. And interestingly, just one company said that they have an employee who is responsible for knowledge management. So that meant a lot of work for us within the project. In the next section, role of knowledge management within those companies, 72% replied that they have a business strategy. This is good. But 81% of those who have business strategy do not have a knowledge management strategy within the business strategy. So, but all reply, most of them reply that they find the knowledge management very important for them. And contradictory to those previous answers, they said that they have investments in knowledge management, probably some knowledge management tools. And later on, we find out that we have the same situation, and this is nothing strange, but all the investments are done without some wider vision or some directed strategy. So they just buy something what they think they need, but they do not have a broader idea why do they need it, and is there something else that they could use as well. And in practice, more than a half of them say that they have some central storage of some documents or some information, and 36% of them said that they still use PCs of individual employees to store important important data. So this is not, this was not very good. And only one said they use some cloud services for storing storing information. And this is done in I think February and March in 2014. So I think till now lots of change, and now we also use a lot of cloud services. So, but at that time, just one company said they use some of the cloud solutions, and they said they listed some tools that they use, but they put the biggest emphasis on analog. We call them analog tools. So it's like this morning coffee or some meetings. This is the more. This was the most important for them for sharing sharing knowledge. And most of them say that they would prefer one-day trainings, and they would not like to have it in more days, because it was understandable. These were small companies, and they could not go and leave their offices for such a long time. And they wanted to have this online phase of the training, and luckily we were able to provide them. Now we have a course which is free for everyone, and this is online course that you can find the link probably on our project's website. Then what was our conclusion in this first phase of the project? So it seemed to us that not many companies were interested in knowledge management. They did not have an idea what it is and what tools do they need. We also got some contradictory answers. Well, it's also okay, because we received just 11 questionnaires back, and this is not a big number that we can exclude some answers which are not maybe to accordance to other answers. And we, as I said, we had just one example of some cloud or web 2.0 tools they use for knowledge management. And they put the biggest emphasis on these analog tools, so it's still this meeting, having coffees or meeting regular weekly meetings where they discuss some things, but they did not use any system to store their and share their knowledge. And this is just, this is a desk research, but results for all countries involved, and you can see it's quite similar to our conclusion conclusions in Croatia. So you can just you can see that mostly big companies have written knowledge management strategies, and very interesting this information that most knowledge management initiatives, at least a big part of it, were abandoned after they even started something in this field. And then after receiving this feedback from companies and becoming very worried about our success of our project, we also took a look at our own case study. So we do not have a documented knowledge management strategy, and we are the faculty, so knowledge is our core product. So we are offering knowledge to our students, and we are offering knowledge in our research, but we do not have any knowledge management strategy. So, but we were using a lot of knowledge management tools, and only in that point of time we identified them as a knowledge management tool. So we had Alfresco for document repository. We were using all Google services, Dropbox. We were using e-portfolio system for keeping track of our employees. We were using, of course, e-learning system. We are using Moodle, and we developed some systems for learning management systems on our own. So we were using a lot of such tools, but we did not have a clear strategy why we use it, for what we are using, or so this was very embarrassing for us as well. And also, because we are faculty, there is a lot of people, more than 120, and all researchers, scientists, teachers have their own fields of expertise. We also identified few experts in knowledge management within our own house. And then we approached them and asked, do you want to participate in this project? It is about to give support to small and medium-sized companies, providing trainings about knowledge management and tools for knowledge management. But they said, this is not our field. So they were researching knowledge management, but for some archives or some library purposes, things like this. So it was not applicable to small and medium-sized enterprises. So we were sorry about that. And even identifying those people that they are dealing with knowledge management only when we had some issues in the project was also a failure for us, because otherwise, if we would, would have a good system, we would identify them much sooner. And then we had a series of trainings, and we were really serious about those trainings, because we were afraid, because of this initial low response from companies, that we will have no one participating our training. So we invested quite a lot in providing information to our contacts and explaining what is knowledge management, how why it's important, and things like this. And luckily, we even organized more workshops than it was initially planned, because we had a really good feedback. And out of 21 workshops done within the project, 6 workshops were done in Croatia, with a total of 134 participants. So it's almost half of all participants. So this was a good sign, and now at that moment we felt more confident in our success with the project. During this training phase, we had the invited lecture. This is Professor Huljenić, who works in one Croatian company called Ericsson Nikola Tesla, but he's also professor in another faculty. So he was giving a training, and within this training, he provided some information about the knowledge management system within his own company. So this company is quite large for Croatian economy, so it's more than 1 1,700 employees, and it's a very advanced company. They have more than 90% of higher education degree employees, and 15% of all employees are PhDs. So it's a global company. They have businesses around the world. So they are a very good example of a company who really appreciates its knowledge and takes good care of it. So he presented us some information, and I really like this example of knowledge doubling. So it's really clear that we are living in a knowledge-driven society, and those who are not managing knowledge, who are not capable of very fast learning and sharing their knowledge, I think those do not have a future. So he was describing their assets in knowledge management. So they have a knowledge portal. You'll see a screenshot of it. They have a lessons learned database. They have a system for finding or locating expertise within the company. And they have a community of practice. And behind all those systems, there is a system of rewarding. And so if you are actively participating those communities, you get some benefits in terms of salary, whatever. So it's very active within their company. So you can see this screenshot of their knowledge portal. Probably you cannot read because it's really small letters, but I will read it for you. This is Asset Library blog, Ericsson Project Place, Global Knowledge Objects, and MyNet, and some other links. So this system is really important for them, and it's he said that they use it daily, but almost like it's open all the time during their working hours. So. And on my next slide, you will see departments, and you'll see that almost each department has some kind of knowledge management system to support it. And later on, we find a connection to our small companies, because to us it seemed like this is a big company, but this is not a single knowledge management system like a large system, but they also have a small department knowledge management systems, which can be replicable also to some small and medium-sized enterprises. And this is his own words, why they use knowledge management, what are the benefits of it within their company. So you can see this is not some kind of pilot implementation. I think it's in the core of their business strategy to have a system like this. And we also use this for motivating companies in this pilot, the last phase of the project, when we try to implement knowledge management system in five companies. When we said, okay, you have a you can easily imagine a scenario where you lose some employee. Does this employee takes all the knowledge with him or her, or there is a way that you can keep this knowledge and in a way to easier transfer this knowledge to a new employee? And this was really catch for them, and we based all the other activities when communicating with companies using this scenario. And this is the last phase of the project, where we really try to start knowledge management systems in five companies, which did not have it before. So there is a, those five companies come from different sectors, and you can see they're really small companies. But they already used some knowledge management tools, but this application was not structured, or they do not consider it as a knowledge management. So we had a really good ground to work with them. We had a first meeting, so we gave some introduction of the project. We presented them the handbook. You all have it in your bags. So we gave them some materials to read, to think about this, and we planned the next meeting after they get some insight to knowledge management, and they will plan some concrete steps after this initial phase. So we had some kind of questionnaire to catch this as-is state, and later on we also compare this to this as-is state, and we had a really good success in working with those companies. So after initial meetings, we decided on the tools that they will use and the timeline, and they had a 1 month period to test the tools and to try to make some organizational changes within the companies, and then we continue to work them. But during that time, we also had a close contact with them. It was on a weekly basis. So this is the second meeting, and those are steps that we took. And this is our knowledge management strategy, methodology, sorry, and it's described in the handbook. So we followed those steps. The first step was accessing the current situation, so taking as-is state. This is where we are now. And then giving some simple answers to where we want to be, how to get there, and after this initial sessions with them, we had some proposal for their strategy that they developed even more during this pilot phase. So we followed all those steps. They used different tools. Probably you also use most of those tools. And they said that for them it's very important to have a regular staff meetings, otherwise it will not work. And they stick to this even after finishing our pilot phase. So those are results in the end. So of course, now they know what is knowledge management. They have a different view on it. They see it more strategically now. They adopted some new procedures. They have this regular weekly meetings. They created some guidelines which are written, and all new employees and all employees can easily find it. They have a better information flows, increased productivity, and all the other benefits listed in this slide. So they also had some problems in this pilot implementation phase, and mostly it's a additional workload that they have to do now. They did not have to do it before this introducing this knowledge management strategy and system. So this was the biggest complaint. And but I think it's only for current employees, but all new employees who will start to do it like this from the first day, I think it will not be an issue because it will be normal for them. And yeah, all the others is just resistance to change, but it is not just for small companies. I think it's for all organizations. So, but they still find it's a very powerful tool, knowledge management tools for their businesses, and they will keep developing knowledge management with their companies. So, after all those project phases, I will present you what are our findings after this experience. So, I think it's not a question that knowledge management is critical for not just for SMEs, but for all companies, and not just companies, but also public institutions like universities. So you saw in previous slide how fast knowledge is doubling. So if you are not capable of getting that knowledge very fast, you will stay behind. So it's not a doubt that this is critical for all institutions. And benefits of knowledge management are still not fully exploited by SMEs. I think big companies are way ahead, but it's not a negative thing for SMEs to stay behind, because these big companies had to invest a lot, to test a lot, and probably they failed a lot. So now it's cheaper for smaller companies to get some knowledge from their experience. And and Web 2.0 tools, which are widely available, make it really cheaper to introduce some of those tools. So if you are small, you don't need the custom-made systems like big companies have. You can use something which is available, and in some cases even for free. Most of companies do not have this explicit knowledge repositories, one place where they store knowledge and one place where they go and seek this knowledge. So mostly this storage is within the manager's head or owner's head, but somehow, despite not having such systems, they were quite successful in managing knowledge. So this is a small number of people, and these interpersonal links are very strong. So they communicate more, they exchange knowledge, and they have their own ways of keeping and keeping knowledge or sharing knowledge within the company. And they have a resource constraint, so they cannot invest a lot in some systems, but as I said, there are lots of Web 2.0 free tools that they can use, so it's not a big investment for them. And I already mentioned few of our conclusions from this side, but this can be very useful for them, because even in a big companies, they split their big systems to a department level, and such systems are used with a limited number of people. So this can be very useful for small and medium-sized enterprises as well. And this knowledge management initiatives, it's not just a question of ICT, of a tool that they will use. We found out that even more important than the tool itself, because tools and market is developing, there are new tools coming every day. But this social and organizational aspect of bringing change to organization, is the most important. So it's not a matter of a tool, but if you don't have a support and really belief of a management that they need knowledge management to be structured, it's no success. So it has to be both. And my final thought is on this knowledge-driven economy, which will not change in any time soon. So our biggest resource is knowledge, and we will have to sooner or later start to think about knowledge on this structured way, and we will have to introduce some knowledge management strategies, and we will have to invest a lot of efforts on managing our knowledge in the future. So I thank you for your attention, and I will be happy if I get some questions from the audience.
Dokładnie. Zachęcamy Państwa do zadawania pytań. Już mamy jedno.
Thank you very much for your very informative and entertaining and last but not least very open and honest presentation. It was really a pleasure to listen to you. I would like to go back to the example you used about FOI. Did your faculty manage finally to develop such a knowledge management strategy, and how their attitude has changed toward it? Thank you very much.
Thank you for the question. It's I hope this is not being recorded, but I will go to a slide at the beginning to illustrate my answer. So this is our building. This is old Jesuit monastery. It's from 17th century, but although it's very old, inside we have a very modern equipment, and it's an IT faculty. And even this IT history, we are also quite old. We were founded in 1974. But despite having knowledge as our main product, doing research, finding some new things, we are very slow in changing ourselves. So because of this project, we started to think about knowledge management. But to be honest, from the time when we identified some issue, we did not made any big progress. So we still have a lot of different systems that we use, and there is no a single document saying why we are using some systems, what is the purpose, what is the future development of some aspects. So unfortunately, not much done on this institutional level.
More questions? Więcej pytań? Yes.
I would like to ask you, after this investigation, which element of this work is much better in Croatia than in Poland? So, saying shortly, what we can learn from you and what you can learn from us, from Poland. This is the first part. And the second part is, when I have a look on the cultural elements, which you mentioned just on the latest slide, you underline the cultural aspect's importance. When I have a look on the Hofstede cultural model comparison between Poland and Croatia, I see that in terms of the dimension of power of distance, you are much higher than Poland. How the power of distance, which is high, is impacting the knowledge management?
Well, to give the first part of my answer, unfortunately, you cannot learn a lot from a Croatian example, but I think it's also a good thing for you to learn that you are good in something. So in collaboration with Marta and her team, I think Croatia is not so developed considering knowledge management. In the first phase, we tried to identify some expertise points in Croatia, and we could not find a single company which is registered for giving support or services in knowledge management. So there's just few companies which mention knowledge management, but beside all the other services, business services that they provide. So there is not a single a consultant I can name now who is really expert and famous in Croatia giving consultancy knowledge management. And even software development companies that we met, they produce knowledge management tools, but they do not market it as a knowledge management tool. It's a tool for something, but not for knowledge management. So I think we are quite low in this awareness of knowledge management. So we do things, but we do not consider this as a knowledge management. So in this sense, I think you are much better and reply Marta gained from the companies was much better than we in Croatia. So we had these 11 companies which filled the questionnaires, but half of those companies were like private contacts. We had to call someone, please, can you fill this up? So like companies are on their own and not want to share the knowledge or to meet others. So it's at least I feel like this in Croatia. And other part of the answer, I'm not sure if I understood the right this distance factor, but Croatia is a small country. It's 4.5 million people, so it's a small market, and we don't have a big influence globally. Like our economy is not very important globally, so that's why I think this knowledge management approach, research, or even considering knowledge as a very important thing, it's not at least in this economy sense very very important.
Okay, maybe I will add something to Amir's answer, because I think that we have something to learn, that we can learn from Croatian companies, because when you look at the numbers of people who participated in the workshops, the number of participants from Croatia is the middle of all the participants we had in all other countries. So what we can learn from our Croatian partners is that we have to be more interested in knowledge management. So this is why also we wanted to meet with you today, because this is a good example from Croatia. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Marta.
Do we have more questions? Więcej pytań?
Maybe I help you with regarding the Croatian situation with the knowledge, because when I have a look in the Global Innovation Index report, you know this, yeah. Recently, which was submitted 17th of September this year, is showing that knowledge impact on innovation in the economy. In your country, you are on the 34th position. There were 140 countries. And Poland is 81st, so you are much better in that.
Well, as I said, knowledge management is not linked to innovation and in such a way. So it's like knowledge management in Croatia is something that professors at economy faculty do some research, but in small and medium-sized companies, it's not a very important topic. But why we rank probably very high on this list, we have a really good support from the government in innovation, a lot of investment, a lot of public-funded agencies that provide a lot of funding for and support for innovation, for a clean industry, for things like that. So I think we have a really good higher education system, but it's more result of this and not about knowledge management as some field of research that is done in Croatia. So, besides this European funding that we have really large money from our own sources, and probably it will become shorter when we start to use these European funds more seriously, because we are the latest to join EU.
Okay, thank you very much, Amir, for your presentation and all answers.